Thank you. Thank you. he's older now, but he still talks about that.
Yeah, yeah.
He couldn't believe that we actually did that.
I think you made quite the impression.
Thank you. Hi, good afternoon, everyone. My name is Chris Froh.
Oh.
I definitely will not tell you to hold your applause. That's wonderful. Thank you. I'm Chris Froh. I teach percussion here at UC Davis. I'm so delighted to have you here today. This concert has a title. I'd never give concerts titles, but today it felt really appropriate to do so. When the first stay-at-home order was issued in March of 2020, we were just about to welcome the wonderful quartet Sandbox Percussion to UC Davis for a residency at the Mondavi Center, where they were scheduled to premiere a new evening-length piece by composer Andy Akiho, a piece called Seven Pillars. This is a project they've been working on for, I think, 4 or 5 years already. And then the pandemic struck, and we all went underground. Our ensemble had also been preparing to play a big concert when Sandbox was here and to be working with them on another piece. And instead, we found ourselves in our homes, like all of you, and we had to adapt. So we, since the internet is not equipped to handle rehearsing music together, we went with some pieces that required less precise synchronization, pieces like radio music, what you just heard a few minutes ago. Then as the pandemic stretched on, we were forced to find other ways to adapt, and we found some ultra-low latency audio monitoring software so that we could rehearse more or less traditional music, but from our homes, over the internet. However, students generally did not have marimbas and xylophones in their homes, so we were forced to find pieces that used instruments that could be shipped to them, pieces like scratch for these scrapers that you just heard. Then as the restrictions continued to be lifted, back last spring, we were fortunate to be able to come back to campus and actually rehearse together again, outdoors in small group settings. And so we dug back into some of the pieces that we had been working on before, pieces that were traditional pieces like Rainbows that you just heard. Now, what binds all of those pieces together is that we never had a chance to perform any of them, hence the loose ends that we're attempting to tie up in one way or another. This next piece, the last piece in the program today, Karakure Nai, is a pretty big loose end. It's the piece that we were supposed to perform with Sandbox Percussion during their residency. And Sandbox was so generous, their gig got canceled, but they still offered to work with the students, and they recorded a bunch of tutorials for them. They conducted, I think it was like a 19-hour long Zoom session where they talked through the piece and possible arrangements of the piece. They were very, very generous with their time, and so grateful to them for doing that. I feel like it's appropriate to maybe dedicate this arrangement that we've come up with over this quarter to Sandbox, and thanks for their friendship and their fellowship. As it turns out, the universe works in mysterious ways, and Sandbox Percussion right now is in Seattle at a dress rehearsal at Emerald City Music for that Andy Akiho piece that they were supposed to premiere 2 years ago, the piece Seven Pillars, for which they've been nominated for, I think, like 5 Grammy Awards. Maybe that might be a bit strident, but multiple Grammy Awards for the recording of that piece. So we're so delighted that our performance will coincide in a way with theirs. I think that we're ready to go, except for me. I hope you enjoy, and Sandbox enjoys. Karakure Nai. Thanks for coming.